is tonight's tale of the tape. Here once more is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC flyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, Erin and now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, Thug Rose Namajunas!
Ready to fight? Ready. Good.
All right, Thug Rose Namajunas ready to go here. Round one, Trevor Whitman firmly in her corner and might be a little bit of a feeling out process here tonight. She's not afraid to see what's coming back before registering her attack. Rose Namajunas in another big one tonight. All right, so Thug Rose Namajunas mixing it up pretty well here in the early going with her kicks and, of course, that patented jab as well.
Yeah, she pops that jab. She's so fast that you can hear her corner telling her, Rose, stay on the jab, stay on the jab. She's so good at maintaining distance, and she's very tall for the weight class. Rose Namajunas has now figured out how to use her length to her advantage inside the octagon.
How clean is that jab by Rose Namajunas? Blanchfield gets the early takedown. Right into side control. Nicely done. Erin Blanchfield's trying for a submission here.
She's starting to advance. It's very deep now. She's so smart, John. She maintained position over submission. That's rule number one. And now she has her back.
Blanchfield's got the full mount. All right, she's in the full guard here, DC.
She's going to be looking to pass, try to get to the next position.
Blanchfield's back in half goal. Two minutes have gone by here, round one. DC, I know you got my back. She's got her back, and she can do a lot of damage from here.
I've got your back, as I'm your boy, J.A. She's got her back as if she wants to end her night right now. She's got to be very careful.
Blanchfield is able to flatten her out. This could be real trouble now. Trying to stay heavy here as best she can. Erin Blanchfield's back in side control. Oh, in good position to rip off a Kimura here. Oh, that looks tight. Oh, she got out. How good is that? All right, so after a great back-and-forth engagement on the ground, the fighters get back to their feet, and the crowd really showing their support for these two women.
The crowd goes crazy because they appreciate the high-level grappling that these two women just exhibited for them. Big shot to the body. Ooh, big shot land.
Oh, you talk about mixing the martial arts. Perfect strategy here. She's got her back now.
Scramble and go! Scramble and
oh, right into mount.
Blanchfield's going for an arm here. Ooh, arms in tight. Oh, that looks painful. That's gotta be it. Oh, she's out!
Wow, way to stay calm in a tough situation and defend that arm. Look at that, going into the arm bar. What a tight arm bar.
Oh, tremendous escape by her there.
Beautiful submission defense on display by this young lady.
Well, working pretty effectively from the top here. Nice ground and pound by Erin Blanchfield. Another ground and pound strike lands.
That was nice.
Oh, effective utilization of the ground and pound here by Erin Blanchfield. guard here if you're the bottom fighter, trying to prevent the half guard, I would assume.
Yes, absolutely. Trying to keep her in full guard, throw up some submissions to get back to your feet.
Well, she continues to... Oh, she's got a triangle, and that one is tight. She told us before the fight on Thursday that she was going to have to be put to sleep. She wasn't going to tap. Easier said than done right here.
Well, she's going to have to tap, or she's got to circle away from the trapdoor, get her knee on the belly, and start to get her posture up. But as she does that, she needs to make sure she is not leaving her arm behind where she can get caught in the armbar. Beautiful ground strikes landed.
Round
two next.
Stop.
All right, there's the horn, DC. We'll look back at some of the highlights from that previous round, and you know what she does. She grounds you, she pounds you.
Yeah, you know it's coming, but it's on you to try to change it. It's on you to stop the result. It's on you to change the narrative of the fight. She says, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I'm going to get you there, and I'm going to pound your face into the ground. That's exactly what she did at the close of that round.
All right, round two. All right, champ, here we go with our next round. There are a lot of bad spots you can be in mixed martial arts, but I can't think of many worse ones than being underneath this ground and pound attack. That was insane.
No, she is a beast when it comes to the ground and pound. Hey, on your back in a triangle body or whatever the body... On your back in the body triangle, it sucks. But what's much worse is being underneath this young lady while she's got posture trying to finish you. It is brutal to watch. She has big power. She winds up everything, and she is so accurate that she can almost guess where you're going to move when she's going to throw her strikes, and they land with some force.
Oh, she's mean. She's literally trying to rearrange your face.
She's like, trying to
rearrange. She will want your relatives to recognize you after the fight.
And you,
Blanchfield's trying to lock up on a submission now. Oh, tense moment here. That arm triangle's tight. Oh, she bails on the sun. Nice ground strikes landed by her here from top position. All right, so the jab lands yet again for Thug Rose Namajunas, really starting to mix things up well on the feet.
She does it all. I mean, I think Rose Namajunas is one of the best athletes in the strawweight division. She fights long. She stays behind the jab, but she uses her kicks to make sure that she's at range and safe. She gains separation, breaks that clinch position. Shots.
Punishing kick there. Just missed with the left there. Oh, she works the body as well as anybody in this division. Another strike there, and these shots are really going to take their toll as this fight moves on. 3 minutes to go.
Liver kick, if you take those kicks, it's going to shut your body up. Once you take that many kicks, it doesn't matter if they're hard or not. Those are a lot of kicks.
Yet another strike targeting that already bruised area on her body. I'm not sure how many more of those she wants to take.
No, she needs to defend these. John, she's got to drop the elbow. She's got to tuck it. She's got... Oh, Kimura tag. Yep.
Oh, she's got that Kimura locked in tight. We pass the midpoint here of the fight. All right, nice transition into full guard. If you're the top fighter, where do you go from here?
Try to posture up, get some big ground and pound off, which will lead to you passing the half guard.
Well, her grappling has been very strong thus far, and when she's putting it all together like this, takedowns, ground control, I'm not sure there's a woman in this division that can hang.
Not many people can hang with what she's trying to do. She's so good at controlling when she gets this takedown, and that's on full display right now.
Blanchfield's in half guard.
Nice transition.
Well, she did not miss a single grappling practice during this training camp, and here's your evidence. Outstanding movement on the ground.
She looks like a master.
Arm triangle attempt by her here.
Arm triangle.
Ooh, look how tight that arm triangle is.
Oh, yeah, she's got it deep.
And there it is!
Goodness!
As many star points as you could produce. Whoa! absolutely remarkable what this fighter was able to accomplish here tonight. Really nice job by her there to execute the submission. Clearly, she had an opening, and she closed the show pretty effectively there. That is one of the bigger wins of her UFC career. All right, the official decision is in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 32 seconds of round number 2. For the winner by submission, Erin
Well, really nice to see this young woman get a chance to exhale as she celebrates with her coaches. You've won world titles in 2 divisions, but you're not calling your shot the way she is. She said, I'm going to win.